a year-round tropical paradise and home to thousands of exquisite plants, butterflies, moths, birds, and bugs. The Cambridge Butterfly Conservatory has been a remarkable institution in Waterloo Region since 2001. As a privately owned Canadian corporation, it is entirely self-reliant and must juggle the business of attraction with the responsibility of education, research, and conservation. Andalyne Tofflemire, Conservatory Manager and Naturalist, tours viewers throughout the magical 25,000 square foot facility and its daily behind the scenes operations.
Butterflies are important because of their role in nature, but they definitely resonate more strongly with people than other insects, which is partly why a butterfly conservatory was built. It's a very magical, special place. You can just appreciate the beauty or the symbol that a butterfly is. It could be the gateway insect. You could walk out into the middle of a grassy meadow and there were like dozens of things at my feet, whereas you sometimes have to chase after birds, right? So I think I was drawn to insects because you don't have to go far to see a whole bunch of really neat things. I'm very involved with the feeding and the daily care of the animals and just the tropical greenhouse in general. I oversee the horticultural department because the plant care is it's one of its own things completely as well. The education department because we do usually offer a lot of school programming, day camps, guided tours, as well as the daily nature interpretation that's going on to engage guests, so that education takes on a few faces. I do help out frontline or gift store admissions or anything where as needed. So it, as I say, it involves a bit of everything. I've been here a little over 10 years now. On any given day you come, there's upwards of 2,000 free-flying butterflies flying around. We import them from tropical butterfly farms where they're sustainably raised as a way to conserve rainforest habitat. So every week or every 2 weeks we get usually 1,000 or 1,500 chrysalids or cocoons, and we put them up in the window so that people can see the butterflies emerge, dry off their wings, and then they live out their butterfly and moth lives in the conservatory. It's a 10,000 square foot greenhouse, so it's one of the larger ones in North America actually, which is really nice. And then we have the two gallery spaces where you can, it's kind of the more museum feel. There's some butterflies on display on cabinets and then the live bugs, but so there's kind of a bit of both. You know, we're a locally owned independent business, so we're pretty kind of small team, very, very tightly knit. When I get to share a really fun thing with someone and they have their eyes open to something new, or they just observe something they wouldn't usually get to, that window we saw with all the chrysalids. I mean, how often do you get to see a chrysalis or a butterfly emerge? So it's being part of those special, unique moments is pretty neat. Hopefully a bit of appreciation we instill in people for butterflies or other kinds of insects as well, because hopefully they can take that with them and maybe put it into action, conservation, some things like that. But also, we're a really special place for special moments. We do weddings, we have celebrations of life. We've had people propose here. So we hear a lot of stories from families that have experienced some of those really special moments here, and they share those stories with us, which makes all the staff feel pretty happy. We've been open for going on 20 years now, so I guess that has also been long enough. We hear lots of great stories, and it means a lot.